Hello and welcome to our coverage of the WNBA on 2K Sports. Moments away, it'll be the Minnesota Lynx going up against the Indiana Fever. Oh, I know the three of us think this is the best league in the world. So I have to ask, who's the best player in the league?
I can only pick one? Okay, let's think. I'm going to have to go with 2020 MVP Asia Wilson. In a small ball era, Wilson doesn't even take threes. She owns the paint, is a double-double machine, and even led the league in blocks.
I'll give you that. Wilson, a great pick. But I'm going with Breanna Stewart, an MVP in this league, a couple finals MVPs as well. Just a 6'4 scoring machine. She can shoot it as good as anyone. I mean, watching her play, you have no idea how anybody can slow her down.
Now here's Robinson. Mitchell, shot's good.
That play shows you that Mitchell doesn't have to be ball dominant to be effective. She can just catch and shoot.
Dantas outside. Pass to Clarendon. Now here's Fowles.
McCowan defending.
Clock at six. Faded away to create the space.
A sound scorer like Fowles has to be able to score buckets through some contact. And really, she's as resilient as they come.
Now here's Vivian's. Mitchell outside. And the Fever hit again from deep.
Right out of the gates, and they are locked and loaded. No misses and three scores early.
You gotta love Kelsey Mitchell's offensive game. She's got a terrific shot and knows how to put it to work, usually collecting plenty of points for her team.
Collier up top.
McCowan defending.
Another one falls for Minnesota.
Love Collier's discipline on offense. Looks for a shot she likes and dedicates to it.
Pass to Vivian's. Here's Mitchell. Now McCowan. Here's Mitchell. And it's blocked by Sylvia Fowles.
What a rejection from Fowles. Her timing and toughness really cement her as one of the league's best defenders.
And something to also appreciate about Mitchell's offense is that she doesn't waste many shots.
Yeah, and that efficiency, a big part of why she's had multiple seasons as one of the top 10 scorers in the league. Red hot out of the gates, 4-for-4 shooting.
Outside Robinson, pass to Mitchell.
Tierra McCowan, high post.
Poked away, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Fever will retain possession. And here in the first, about 3 minutes in. And that one's good, Vivian.
Nice find by Lavender. She doesn't pile up the assist, but that player was open and she wasn't missing it.
Pass to Fowles. McBride. And that comes off the assist by Sylvia Fowles.
Three's going down quickly at both ends.
What an answer. You come at me with the three, I'm coming right back.
Everybody gets a three.
Now here's Robinson. Mitchell left side. Now here's Lavender. Shot clock at six. For three, Victoria Vivian's. Rebounded by McBride. Minnesota trailing. Here's Clarendon. The shot goes down and it gets this game back to even.
It's great to see Dantas continue to develop as a playmaker. Her court vision just keeps getting better.
Pass to Lavender. And here's Vivian's.
Covered by Collier.
Mitchell with it. In the hoop for her third make from the field. She's 3-for-4 thus far in the contest.
And that's pretty much an unguardable move from Mitchell. So skilled and composed with the ball in her hands.
Now here's Dantas.
No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. Pass to Fowles. Over Robinson. And it's Minnesota scoring again.
How many difficult shots has Fowles made in her career? Just an incredible spirit about her game. Not to be denied.
Here's Robinson.
Lavender inside, covered by Collier. Outside, Didions.
Good on the triple.
Superb assist. She was crafty, creative, and the ultimate teammate on that play.
McBride outside. Back to Clarendon. Collier outside.
Tried to answer back, but that three is off the mark.
Here's Lavender. Up again. Great positioning on the putback.
What an absolute force McCowan is down low. The board, the points, what a talent.
McBride outside. Pass to Clarendon. McBride with the ball. Now Mitchell defending. Collier with it. He's against Lavender. And that one's good. Collier. The Fever with the lead. Outside Robinson. Now Lavender. Now here's Vivian's. Kicks it out to Mitchell.
And the Fever hit again from deep.
She is showing a killer instinct this quarter, looking to extend this lead.
Collier outside. McBride, pass to Fowles. Outside Clarendon. To the paint.
Here's McBride. And the layup is good.
Finishing plays around the basket with various strong finishes. McBride is feared whenever she's on the court.
Now here is Robinson. For three, Victoria Vivians.
And the Fever hit again from deep.
Now they're getting their points now almost exclusively from three-point range. Four of the last five makes from beyond the arc.
And the defense practically giving them those shots.
And they'll take them. Both teams on fire right now from the opening tip.
This is going to be an entertaining game of basketball today, folks. I think that much is obvious.
Get your popcorn ready.
And they're scoring pretty well as we conclude the first quarter. The Fever on top, leading by five. And we'll be back shortly for the start of the second quarter. All right, the second quarter beginning in just a moment. And what stands out to you from the Fever in this one?
Scoring has come in threes for the most part so far.
Yeah, and every time down the floor, it seems like they're hitting a triple.
Now Dangerfield. Pass to Banham. Dangerfield.
Sinks the triple.
I want to make it as a WNBA player at the guard position. You need a deep shot like Dangerfield.
The 2020 Rookie of the Year, Crystal Dangerfield was the lowest draft selection to ever win the award.
Here's Mitchell. Count that one.
She got a little room at the rim and laid it in. I like that play.
Pass to Fowles. Powers. Back to Fowles. Powers.
And the Lynx, another three.
Selected in the second round, Dangerfield also led her team in scoring as a rookie, but her role changed in her second season.
That's right. Dangerfield moved to the bench early on in the season. And while that would be maybe tough for some, Dangerfield has accepted the role. She thrives in that six women role. And that speaks to her maturity, showing that she could be effective starting her off the bench.
Pass to Fowles. Now Banham.
And just about a minute and a half has passed here in the second quarter.
McCowan with the ball. Here's Allen. She hasn't yet put up any points in this one.
And here's McCowan.
Five to shoot. Let's go with a three.
And the Fever hit again from deep.
Good ball movement. She put that pass in the ideal spot, and I can guarantee you her teammate appreciates it.
Now a timeout called by Minnesota.
As the years have gone by, we've seen less centers, less bigs, and rosters go guard heavy. Why is that?
Well, we've seen a massive shift to the three-point shot. Threes are attempted just about 50% more over the last couple seasons than the start of last decade. So the emphasis is on shooting, and it's led to a more perimeter-based game.
That and the teams have gone with small ball. It's been proven that you can win with three, sometimes four guard lineups.
And here in the second, 2 minutes gone by.
Outside of Chanwa. Here's Fowles. She's got six. Six to shoot. Here's Dangerfield. And that one drops.
High degree of difficulty on that hoop. Dangerfield, not at all, letting it phase her.
Quarter two and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. To the wing, right side. Here's Mitchell. Yes, and it's Jessica Breland with the assist that time.
That's a great job, really, to angle her body, shield the bigger player from the ball on her way to the basket.
And you have to know how to finish like that if you're going to take it down low. And she showed all the capabilities of doing so. Oh, man, she is so good at making those lead passes.
Pass to McCowan. From downtown,
Breland.
She hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Phenomenal effort. Breland creates scoring chances for herself by relentlessly working on the offensive glass.
Outside Powers. Bantam. Six on the shot clock. Launches it. She's now 1 for 2 with that bucket.
I mean, that shot just becomes effortless for her when the defense is so relaxed like that.
Over to the wing. Covered by Collier. Here's Mitchell. That's her fourth basket of this game, and she's only taken four shots. Off to a good start.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now. I mean, there's more holes in their defense than in a block of Swiss cheese.
Man, you just made me hungry, but that's right. Five of their last six makes were in tight. They've established themselves inside. And where's the cheese?
Timeout called the Fever.
And talking about getting no respect, despite her talent, Dangerfield dropped to the mid-second round of the 2020 draft. She quickly proved that was a mistake.
Pass to Vivians. Now Robinson. On the wing, Kelsey Mitchell. Takes the 13-footer. Score the bucket. She's made five so far, shooting a nifty 5 for 7. And Dangerfield got the respect she deserved, winning Rookie of the Year.
And looking to build on that first season, she's been working hard in the gym to polish her game. I view her as one of the bright young talents in this league. I'm not sure that was the play they had set up, but it was too good a look to pass up.
Outside Robinson. Lavender outside. Clock at 4. The 3 from Kelsey Mitchell. It's hauled in by the Lynx.
3 triples for her in the first quarter, but she's yet to knock one down in the second.
Outside Clarendon.
A piece of Collier for three. That's good, and it's Leija Clarendon with the assist.
Zero fear. As soon as she gets the rock, Collier ready to fire.
Mitchell left side. Victoria Vivian's on the wing. Puts up a three. Nailed from three-point land.
She is just bombing it today. How many more threes are we going to see from her?
Well, we've already seen a lot. I mean, she's got more points from outside the arc than inside the arc. She made that pass to a spot and let her teammate run right into it. That is how you distribute the basketball.
Reeland, defended by Achanwa. They double her with Collier. And it's out of bounds to the Fever as Indiana retains possession. Shot clock at six. Here's Robinson. Score the basket. Her second of two attempts.
The physicality not bothering Robinson. In fact, it seems like she relishes the chance to stick it to defenders.
For three, Nafisa Collier. And the Lynx, another three.
They've given up so many threes today.
Their defensive rotations on the perimeter have been abysmal.
Reland outside. And here's Kelsey Mitchell for three. And the Fever hit again from deep.
She's starting to pick up from what she accomplished in the first quarter, where she made three of her three-point attempts.
Here's Clarendon. And the rebound goes to the Fever.
Well, that's just not a sight you see very often because she has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when she's open.
She is feeling it, shooting a terrific percentage from the field.
And so it's a close game as we wrap up the first half of play. Fever ahead, up by five. And don't go away after the break. We'll see you right back here for the start of quarter number three. And now, the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. It's been an absolute clinic out there by Kelsey Mitchell.
Well, she created a lot of good shots for herself in the first couple of quarters. And she knows when to pass up on the tough ones. Good shot selection.
And that led to a very high points per shot number for her. And that's a stat that really tells you how efficient a player has been.
And it's been a back-and-forth game with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter getting started here.
Outside Clarendon.
Pass to Fowles.
Here's Dontas. She's guarded by Lavender.
Here's McCowan. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
The concentration. The fire from McCowan. Wow, able to hit the shot despite the D being all over her.
And that one's good. Fouls.
I know she's doing her best to carry them, but she can only do so much. Things would be different for them if she was getting a little more help.
Pass to Vivian's.
Hey, get that.
Mitchell outside. And they're the Fever with another bucket.
Everyone knows that Kelsey Mitchell can score, so the question is, defensively, how do you slow her down? Well, tonight, they've really had no answers.
Here's Dontas. And that one comes up a bit short. The Fever with the lead.
the backbone of this team's interior play. McCowan really D's up. She's a terrific rebounder, and her size alone can cause matchup problems.
Pass to Collier. Dantas. Clarendon with it.
Jacks up a three. Buries the long-range jumper.
And that's team-first basketball from Dantas. Great work at finding the open teammate there.
And for all she's already accomplished, McCowan's just getting started.
Oh, absolutely. There's just so much upside. A couple areas where she's trying to improve: free throw shooting and range on the jumper.
Collier outside. Releases. It falls for the sixth time in seven tries this contest. That's an 86% accuracy mark. And it's the Fever ball. Lavender outside. Pass to McCowan. Mitchell. McBride covering. Mitchell's shot's good.
They're not rotating quickly enough on defense down low.
They've got to provide more resistance inside.
Now Collier, covered by Vivian's.
Fades!
And it's Collier missing.
You know, it's a quality look right there. Just a little off with her release.
Yeah, and that has her shaking her head. I mean, no way around it. That's a tough miss.
That's her MO. Sometimes she can score more points by herself than the rest of the team combined.
Right outside. Dantas. Here's Collier. It falls for her seventh bucket of the contest. She's 7 for 9 today.
How about that shot going in for Collier? Looked like the contact might disrupt her. Guess it didn't.
Timeout called the Fever.
The league offices, players, and owners have been at the forefront of social justice initiatives. And really, the WNBA has led the way amongst American sports leagues.
Prior to the 2020 season, the league announced the formation of a social justice council led by players including former MVPs Asia Wilson and Breanna Stewart. It was a partnership between the WNBA and its players to find solutions.
The mission of the Social Justice Council: be a driving force of necessary and continuing conversations about race, LGBTQ plus advocacy, and gun control, amongst other important societal issues. And we all from 2K tip our hat to the league and its players for working to enact positive change.
A little under 2.5 minutes off the clock now in the third quarter. Mitchell outside. To the middle. McCowan with the bucket.
That's the third bucket in a row from the paint. And I know nobody likes a traffic jam, but this defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
Yeah, nobody likes a traffic jam. We can agree on that. They can't allow the offense to get those high-quality looks inside.
Here's Dangerfield. He can't hit that time. And Indiana will go the other way with it. Pass to McCowan. Count the basket.
I mean, come on. You think a little tap is going to stop McCowan? No way. She's just too tough.
Now Banham. Collier. She's covered by Mitchell. Here's Dangerfield. Yes, and it's Nafisa Collier picking up the assist.
Way to work the ball in close to the hoop.
Here's Allen. Pass to Lavender. Soft touch off the glass.
Not much resistance on the inside. That's their fifth consecutive make in the paint.
Those looks they're allowing are almost automatic. In fact, I'll just say it, they are automatic.
Here's Banham. Drops in the layup for two.
Took advantage of some shoddy D there. They gotta at least get a finger on her.
Here's Allen. Mitchell outside. Pass to Allen. And she drops it in from the low post.
The center with the assist. You imagine standing at 6'7", McCowan has a clean view of the floor.
Powers with it. He has 5. Dangerfield, that's good.
Check out that assist. That's a pair of teammates on the same page.
Now Allen. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass.
Wow. I mean, come on, that's 10 straight points in the paint. The defense, it's just nowhere to be found.
They have to start committing more bodies down low.
Pass to Banham. Collier. Over Mitchell. Oh, and that one had the right spin on it. It's good.
Yeah, she certainly is not the one to blame for them being in the hole today. She's been right on the money.
Mitchell outside. Good for the 5th time in 5 shots. She remains perfect.
Nicely done. They continue to attack inside. That's 10 points in a row from the paint.
It's now become here it comes and see if you can stop it.
Here's Collier. It drops. That's her 9th field goal of the contest. A blistering hot 9 for 11. 3-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Lavender outside. And another 3 for Indiana.
We're seeing the shots dropping for them very well now.
Yeah, this has been an extremely efficient second half for them up to this point. Their coach has to be happy.
Pass to Banham. From the arc, another 3 for Minnesota.
How about that? Responding to the 3-pointer against them with a quick one of their own.
Yeah, terrific little back and forth right there, Tim.
It's been a lot of fun to watch.
And as we end the 3rd quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. Fever ahead, leading by 10. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter here on 2K Sports. Welcome back as we get set to start the 4th. Now here's Mitchell. Pass to Allen. Breland, covered by Collier. Clock at 6. Here's Mitchell, and she connects with the jumper.
Well, they've built this lead through plays exactly like that. She's easily been the most consistent performer.
No question about that. I mean, she's just hitting everything in sight.
For 3, Kayla McBride. And the rebound goes to the Fever. Here's McCowan. And that one good.
The bounce utilized by McCowan. And once she gets some momentum going to the hoop, get out of the way.
4th quarter, still young. Just over a minute played. And the basket by McBride.
All right, if they think that kind of defense is going to get it done against her, they are sorely mistaken. What's going on out there?
Now Allen. Pass to McCowan. Mitchell. And a miss there on the triple.
Personally, I am shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. She makes you pay on those nearly every time.
And it's good for 2.
And now both of these teams really in a groove here late.
Yeah, and this game was already high scoring, but they've really taken it to another level here down the stretch.
Such a treat to watch, Brian.
Pass to Mitchell. Shoots over Powers. And another basket for Indiana.
Nice, smooth jumper by Mitchell from mid-range. She can attack from almost anywhere on the court.
Ariel Powers on the wing. Inside, Collier, and she makes good on the layup.
Well, she's been the key to their offense. She's been their offense with the way she shot the ball.
Yeah, her percentage today has been through the roof. She is definitely not the one who's put them in this hole.
Knocks down the 3-ball.
I don't care how you look at it. She's having a great game from outside.
Minnesota calls a timeout.
One of the stories here, Mitchell getting it done today.
She is on fire from beyond the arc. They're giving her way too much room, and she's making them pay.
And the Lynx making a change here. Just over 2.5 minutes played now. Final quarter of regulation. Pass to Clarendon. Back to Powers. That's good, and it's Leija Clarendon with the assist.
Well, a player that's effective from three-point land. Powers is at home in the paint, pouring that bucket closer in.
Kelsey Mitchell into the lane. And that one good.
What a top-notch game she's having. And really, she's got her team in front. And it sure seems like she's going to keep them there if she can continue to play like this.
Good.
Good eyes on that play. Fouls is assist numbers. They don't really jump out at you, but she's aware of her surroundings and is capable of making the right play.
And here's Kelsey Mitchell for three.
And there's the call on Tierra McCowan. That'll be her second foul of the game. And the Fever making a change here.
Now the Lynx with it. They trail by 14. Leija Clarendon attacking. Lays it up and banks it in.
Not much the D can do once she gets to the bucket.
And here is Robinson. Outside Vivian's. Pass to McCowan. Six to shoot. Lucky seven drops right in. She's perfect from the floor. 7 for 7.
But when you get this kind of shooting from her, 100% from the field, I mean, they're a tough team to beat. Anybody's tough to beat.
Here's fouls. 6 for 6. She's yet to miss from the field.
Just so efficient from these spots. Fouls is terrific at knowing when she should look to score inside.
Hey, call it out.
Pass to Mitchell. Lavender with it. Vivian's with the ball. And it's Dantas picking her up. Count it.
We're used to seeing her finish in the post.
Here's Clarendon. Now fouls. Lucky seven drops right in. She's perfect from the floor. 7 for 7.
Because of her physical presence down low, fouls remains a dependable interior scoring option.
Timeout called the Fever.
makes it off the glass.
What control from Mitchell there. Even with the contact, she stays with it. Have to admire that kind of effort.
Down low. And that one's good. Fouls.
Hit the bullseye with that assist. Nice delivery into the lane.
Mitchell with it. Outside Robinson. That's in there. Tiffany Mitchell with the assist.
Credit to Robinson there, guiding that ball into the hoop, not allowing the taller players in the lane to swat it away.
To the inside. Fouls. The shot that time, not on target.
Good work defensively by Tierra McCowan.
Pass to Vivians. Lavender. Mitchell with it.
And it's Dantas picking her up.
Tries from 10. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim. Now the Lynx with it. It's a 14-point game. And it's good. 2 points.
In the paint, Dantas insists on getting her shots. Doesn't allow contact to slow her down.
Outside Vivians. Pass to Mitchell. Shot clock at 6.
McCowan.
He's overpowers. And there the Fever with another bucket.
It's so fun to see McCowan pour it in tonight. A true center. Don't see too many like her anymore.
To the middle. Here's Fouls. Hits the jump hook.
This had come earlier. They might have been able to get back into it.
100%. They needed this a lot sooner than they got it.
Yeah, where was this earlier?
Robinson up top. And so it's the Fever taking care of business in this one.
Even early on in this one, it seemed like they were happy to be playing at home tonight.
It makes a big difference. Once they started to really play in a good flow, you felt like they never had any doubts that they come out on top.
And that'll wrap it up.